We have completed the first chapter. I think you have understood the lesson. If you have any doubt, you can ask me. Now let us move on to the second lesson. While we are studying about the subdivisions, we have studied four. Have you remembered the subdivision of economics? What are all the subdivision? Consumption, production, exchange and distribution. Have you remembered? So consumption is the basic thing for all the economic activities. If you are not willing to buy anything, what would happen? Just remember, we don't want to anything. Because of corona, we are all at home. We are not able to go out. So there is no shop, nothing is there. So we don't want to consume anything. We are not going to buy anything. What would happen? How the economy moves? If there is no consumption, there is no production. If there is no production, there is no employment. If there is no employment, there is no income. If there is no income, at last there is no consumption. So the consumption activities is the starting point and also the ending point of an economy. So in this lesson, we are going to study about the consumption analysis. Consumption analysis. What the consumption talks about? What do you mean by consumption? What are all the laws related to that? What are all the theories related to the consumption? Everything we are going to study in the lesson consumption analysis. Already we have studied what is consumption. It is the starting point of economic activities, all the economic activities. The quality and the quantity of consumption determines the standard of living of the people. What do you mean by standard of living? This also we have studied in a previous lesson. The quality and the quantity determines. For example, if you are going to buy, if you want to buy a branded shirt or branded costume, that is quality basis. You are expecting the quality product. We have some brands, isn't it? Whatever we are buying. For example, take the household items. If you want to buy a refrigerator, LG. If you want to buy a furniture, Godrej. There are some branded names. Those are very perfect in the quality and also durability, isn't it? What do you mean by the quantity? Whatever we need, I need a dress. That is enough. I don't bother about the brand and other things. I want to, instead of buying one, I want to buy three. If I buy a branded shirt, I will get only 1,000 rupees. But if I need quantity, I need with the cost of 300, I buy 3. So this is the difference between the quality and the quantity. So this quality and quantity determines the standard of living. The people, those who are preferring the quality, they are rich. Isn't it? It's natural. Sparing 1,000 rupees for a single shirt. Why can't you buy 3? These are the thought of the middle class people and the poor people, isn't it? So, these things determine the standard of living of a people. So, in this theory, we studied about this. And also, we studied consumption is the starting point. Or consumption is the act of satisfying the wants of people. This also you have studied, isn't it? Wants. Our wants are unlimited. That we studied in the basic economic problems, I taught you. People wants, people wants are unlimited with limited resources. So we are going to study about the wants. What do you mean by wants and desire? There is a difference between the wants and desire. Both are seems to be same, but there is a single difference, a slight difference. Desire is Sometimes you can achieve, sometimes you may not achieve. That is desire. But wants, the ability to buy with the desire is called wants. உன்னால ஒரு பொருளை வாங்கி கன்சியூம் பண்ண முடியும் அப்படின்னா அது வாண்ட்ஸ்ல வரும். டிசையர்ல ஆசைப்படுறது எல்லாமே டிசையர். சம்டைம்ஸ் வி மே அச்சீவ், சம்டைம்ஸ் வி மே நாட் அச்சீவ். ஸோ வாண்ட்ஸ் டாக்ஸ் அபவுட் த எபிலிட்டி ஆஃப் பர்ச்சேஸ். ஸோ த கன்சியூமர்ஸ் வாண்ட்ஸ் ஆர் டாக்ஸ் அபவுட் த எபிலிட்டி ஆஃப் பர்ச்சேஸ். அண்ட் தென் வி ஆர் கோயிங் டு ஸ்டடி அபவுட் த ஹியூமன் வாண்ட்ஸ் and the characteristics of human wants, the features or the characteristics of human wants. I already told you wants is the basic thing for the starting period of consumption. So without consumption there is no economic activity. What are the characters? Wants are unlimited, isn't it? As we studied, our wants are unlimited. If one's wants or one of our want has been satisfied, immediately the next wants arise in our heart, isn't it? For example, if you want to buy a or mobile phone during this period, your father asks you, you will ask your father to buy a mobile. At first you prefer for the ordinary mobile, isn't it? If you go on use for 2 to 3 months, what will you prefer? I need a mobile with more features, the best one, the next updated mobile. If you that wants are satisfied, you will go for the next one. Instead of mobile, why can't you buy a tab? It will be more useful, it will be very helpful, it will not affect my eyesight. So we will go for that. If that also satisfied, you will go for a lap, isn't it? So if one want is satisfied, immediately the other wants will arise. ஆசைகள் எப்பவுமே புற்றீசல் போல ஒன்று முடிஞ்சவங்க என்ன செஞ்சிடணும், இமீடியட்டாக த நெக்ஸ்ட் ஸ்டார்டட். பிகாஸ் த ஃபர்ஸ்ட் ஒன் இஸ் சாட்டிஸ்ஃபைட், இஸ் இட் ஆட்டோமேட்டிக்லி த செகண்ட் வில் ஸ்டார்டட். ஸோ ஹியூமன் வாண்ட்ஸ் ஆர் அன்லிமிட்டட் அண்ட் இட் பிகம் ஹேபிட்ஸ். வாண்ட்ஸ் பிகம் habits, habitual actions. The best example for habits is taking a cup of coffee or a tea in the morning time, isn't it? If you ask your mom or dad, they will tell you without taking a cup of coffee or tea, your mom didn't start to work. That is their necessity. They need, they want that particular time. Some people, including myself, if I didn't take a cup of coffee, I feel I had a headache. It's my, what we can say, psychologically, it becomes a habit. For gents, taking cigarettes, that is habits, they are consuming. If they didn't consume that, they may feel something, isn't it? So, sometimes, the wants become habit. You people, while you are traveling, you are using to chew a chewing gum, isn't it? Some people, they used to chew a chewing gum. That is their habits. So because of the habits, the consumption increases. Because of the habits of taking a cup of coffee, the consumption of coffee powder, sugar and also the milk increases. So the wants become, sometimes it becomes habits. And the third one is, wants are satiable. The same thing, we can go for that. such a thing, if one day there is no coffee powder at home, what will you do then? It's a habit, I need it, isn't it? Then I will go for alternative. What I think, if I have tea powder, I will make a tea. I need something to drink hot in the morning time. So, the words have some alternative. Or else, you want to take a parotta or chapati. If there is no availability of parotta or chapati at the hotel, what do you go for? You go for dosa or some other special items, isn't it? So the ones are alternative. You can do some alternative, but anyway you want to satisfy your wants. So wants have some alternative. And then competitive. Wants are competitive. You are going for a purchase. Just think that you are going for a purchase. While you are going for a purchase, you want to buy both garments and also the ornaments to decorate yourself. You have limited sources. I already told you, wants are unlimited, but our resources are limited. We have limited amount of money in our hand, but we want to buy two things. So, the choice will be there. Either if you want to purchase for costly dress, you have to give up ornaments. You have to buy less cost for ornaments. Or else, if you want to pay a gorgeous glittering ornaments, you have to pay less amount for dress. So, you have wants, but they are competitive. You have to choose. You have to choose which is should be given preference. So wants are competitive. If you have two wants at the same time, the wants are competitive. Wants are complementary. You are going to buy a fountain pen, ink pen. You bought a pen. At the same time, you have to buy an ink bottle also, isn't it? If you are buying a car, you have to fill with petrol. If you are buying a two-wheeler, you have to fill with petrol. So, the one wants leads to the wants of another commodity. The wants of buying a two-wheeler leads to the consumption of petrol. So, wants are complementary. The easy example, if you buy a bread, automatically you will buy a jam, isn't it? So, wants are complementary. But actually, you want to buy a slice of bread. But automatically, while you are buying the bread, either will buy a jam or a butter. So, wants are complementary. And then, wants are recurring. What do you mean by recurring? Continuous. As I said, satiable for her. If you feel hungry, if you eat food, your hunger will satisfy after 3 hours. What would happen? Again, you will become hungry, isn't it? You feel hungry, so it comes again and again. So wants are recurring. These are the characteristics of wants. We have seven characteristics. That is, wants are unlimited. It become habits. It is satiable. Alternative wants are alternatives. Competitives, complementary, and recurring. So these are the characteristics of human wants. And classification of goods. The next one is classification of goods. And the next one is classification of wants. Classification of goods. We are going to study the classification of goods. Goods are classified into three. One is necessary. The another one is comfort. Luxury. The easy example I will give you. You need a bicycle to come to school, isn't it? That is necessary. Unless you buy a bicycle, you can't attend the school in the right time. At the same time, if you buy a two-wheeler, that is your comfort. You can come earlier. If you buy a car, that is luxury. But you are coming to the same school to consume your time. If you come a bicycle, that is affordable to you, that is necessary. If you buy a two-wheeler, that is comfort, that is luxury. So already we have studied what are all necessary things, the basic necessity of human being. From 5th standard onwards we are studying what are all the basic necessity: food, clothing and shelter. These are necessary. Without that we can't live, isn't it? So if you go for comfort, we need some comfortable things at home: TV, washing machine, fridge and other thing that we got for our comfortability to make our life easy. Comfort, isn't it? If you go for luxury, not only the car and other things, if you buy diamonds, it shows your standard of living and it shows your richness. So these are the three classification of goods. That is, one is necessary, comfort and luxury. So the people with higher income only buy this comfortable and luxury item, isn't it? The middle income group, they suffered a lot to get their comfortness. The people, those are with higher income, they will afford the comfortability goods and also they will go for luxury goods. So these are the three classification of goods. The next class we will study the utility analysis, cardinal and ordinal utility, JR Keats, given by R.G.D. Allen and J.R. Keats. Utility analysis. Thank you, girls.